Right.
That is the issue. And you've been doing that since the time of Muhammad until the 21st century. That is the issue. Muhammad puts himself in the place where Muslims must worship Allah alone. But Muhammad says, you've got to mention me in your prayer, while all prayers are belong to Allah only. Mention me too. That is the issue.
So Muhammad, he himself is commanding you to commit shirk.
Okay.
Because he's the one who commands, right? Okay, so he's directly telling you, well, when you pray, make sure you mention me.
Can I say? Okay, now.
Do you not see the problem with that?
No, because you don't know something which I know. I'm gonna explain that to you all. You are implying, Muhammad says, mention me in your prayer. But how you mention me? Ask Allah to have mercy on me. So if he was telling us to do shirk, he wouldn't say ask Allah to have mercy on me. He should have said, you should have asked me to help you. Now I'm going to say, this is ambiguous thing. You are making a fuss about an ambiguous thing. I'm going to tell you something clear from the mouth of the Prophet ﷺ. He says, I'm going to give you a reference if you want. In Sahih Bukhari, hadith number 3445. Now what the Prophet himself is telling us, if he asking us to worship him or the otherwise, he says, narrated, look, what's your problem?
No, which Quran are you reading?
You think they're really doing a bad job?
The one is written by God or the other Quran? Any other Quran?
Brother.
I think they can answer.
I'm asking a humble question.
Wait.
Okay.
SubhanAllah. Okay. Narrated Umar radiallahu anhu, I heard the Prophet ﷺ saying, do not exaggerate in praising me as the Christians praise the Son of Mary, for I am only a slave. So call me the slave of Allah and his apostle. He's telling us, do not praise me.
No, doesn't say, it said, do not exaggerate. It doesn't say, do not praise me.
What is it? I'm a slave of Allah.
He said, do not exaggerate in praising me.
You can praise me. As the Christian.
What does the word exaggerate mean?
Exactly.
What you see, you're playing with the words here.
No.
Can't you see the whole context?
Why are you really feeling insecure? The whole point
he's telling you, do not exaggerate in praising me. Yes, you can praise him as a prophet.
You can praise him as a prophet.
Like we.
All the praises belong to Allah.
According to Surah Fatiha, yes, brother.
Hang on.
The human to human, we can praise each other.
Where did you say that?
What is a praise?
No.
Praise, I say, Godwin. I say, Godwin, you are a very smart man.
I'm praising you. Who do all the praise belong to?
In worship is only praise.
What does all mean?
No, it says all.
Does it mean some?
Allah is talking about the worship.
I'm talking about praise.
Surah Al-Fatiha is the context of the worship.
We only worship.
You want me to read Surah Al-Fatiha?
Just the shahud worship.
Can you first respond, Fatih? Break it down for us.
Shahud, not
the issue.
Why do you pray?
Prayer is the part of the worship. Whatever you do in your prayer, that is the part
another
of worship. In your prayer, if you are talking to Allah, that is the part of worship. In your prayer, if you are praising to your wife, that is part of your worship. In your prayer, if you are speaking and mentioning the dead person as that dead person alive, that is worship. Therefore, Muslims, as you mention the dead person in your prayer, as you try to directly speak to that person in your prayer, which Muhammad tells you to do so, you are committing shirk with the permission of Muhammad. You are committing shirk by intentionally following the guidelines of Muhammad.
He did not tell us to worship. He never, ever, in any hadith, in any verse of the Quran.
Is the prayer not
Can I say? You see, you're playing with the words here. You're playing with the words here. Prayer to Allah.
In that. Okay. Let's make it very clear. Abbas, if I stop praying to God, okay, in front of everybody, I stop praying to God, and I start saying, "Oh, Abbas," and I then read the words Abbas, and I start looking at you. And I stop praying, but I'm saying I'm praying to God, but I'm looking at you saying, "Oh Abbas, who am I praying to?"
Allah, but what?
No. I said, listen to my question.
What did he say?
I said, if I say to everybody,
that's
here,
right. Yeah?
I'm going to pray to God.
That's right.
Right? And then, whilst I'm praying, I look at you directly and I say, "Oh Abbas," and I continue my prayer.
And say what?
Who am I speaking?
Say what? Wait. Just say "Oh Abbas."
I'm asking Christian.
If you're just saying "Oh Abbas,"
if I say "Oh Abbas," peace be upon you, Abbas.
Peace of Allah be upon you.
Peace be upon you.
No, peace of Allah. That's what the Tashawwud says.
Abbas, stop hiding.
Peace and mercy of Allah. Read the Tashawwud in English.
Don't let him speak.
Read it.
Abbas, if I say peace be upon you.
Peace be upon your Prophet and mercy of Allah, his blessings be upon you.
Okay.
So mercy of Allah, that's what it is.
Abbas.
Mercy of Allah.
Abbas.
No, but you read the whole of it. You don't just stop there.
See, the problem with the Muslims
here. Why we said that?
It's embarrassing the fact that their own Prophet commanded them to pray to him. It's embarrassing because they call us to Tawheed. They call us to oneness of Allah. They say Allah is one. So how can you have your prayers directed to someone other than Allah if it's not sure? This is a problem.
Let me make a point. Why are you talking to me?
Then why am I here?
If you are praying to Allah, then you hear my voice, people. You need to respond to me, says Muhammad. What is that tell you about Allah and about Muhammad?
That Christ died, that you and I may be corrupted in.